Hi guys, it's Amy and you have found Amy Loves Crochet. Thank you so much for sitting with me today, whether you're a subscriber or this is the first time you've seen me. I do appreciate your time so much. Thank you. Today's video is going to be a part one of maybe two parts, maybe three. I don't know how many times it will take me to work on this, but I've got a whole big pile of things that needed ends to be sewn in or finished pieces of the project. Sometimes if something wasn't quite right, I put it to the side and I was going to try again later. So you have seen this picture now that says all this stuff I've got unfinished and I got to work on all this stuff, and I decided not to start anything more. So the last couple of weeks have been kind of weird because I'm normally starting a new project all the time and, you know, kind of rotating them out. But this time I put down all of my new eyes and just worked on my giant pile of stuff. So here are all my notes that I have to tell you about them. You can see multiple reds here, so let's go ahead and get started. So a couple of things that I had to just tie in some ends on that were my mom's projects. You've seen these in unboxing or whatnot. So this was a beautiful, beautiful double crochet back loop only that my mom started, and it was in a bag with some skeins and a hook. Possibly a hook. I don't know if I had a hook or not. But she's a pretty much a hook H person, a 5mm hook. So I just went ahead and finished the skeins of yarn that she had in there. And then I added a yellow border to it because I thought it needed a little pop there on the edge. And so this one I showed on an unboxing, and I just had a bunch of ends to tie in. And so I did. Now that one's complete. The same thing goes for this one. This was also one of my mom's that she left behind when she passed away in 2009. I got all her yarn, and that included some unfinished projects, which I've got a big doozy one down here. I'll catch up on that one later. it is in this video, whether which side it goes up on, about what's in that tote. So in any event, this one also had a bunch of strings to tie in. Every time she joined a new skein, she just left the tails hanging, so I had a bunch to tie in there. And so now that one's all complete as well. So I can put that one either up on display so I can always think about it, or it can go in a finished tote now. It's not going to be something that I just still have left on the back burner. Yay! Oops. Okay. The next thing that I finished of my mom's was this sweater. I don't know if you guys remember seeing this one as well. And I'll actually insert some pictures here. This is my little grandbaby wearing it. She would not sit still, so sorry for the blur. But yeah, this one is one that my mom did as well, and it had a bunch of strings hanging on it still. She had not tucked in a single solitary one of them. It's not sure. There's a little bit. You can see these sparkles. There's little boom, boom, booms. It's very sparkly, very pretty. Let's see if we can see. You can see some of them here throughout a little bit. So it's very, very pretty, as you can see on my sweet girl. I still have, and I'm not considering this an unfinished project because I haven't started it yet, but from this package, there was some leftover yarn that my mom had worked this sweater in. And so it was all in this, oh, it still smells like her. You know, these zipper bags are really helpful for that. If you have somebody who's passed away and there's a certain scent you want to keep, put it in a plastic zipper bag or something and then go back to it. I have like my mom's socks. She was diabetic, so she had a bunch of compression socks. And so here where I live, it gets really cold in the wintertime sometimes, so I wear those socks and I think of her. So those are all nicely kept in a zipper so that I can still smell her perfume. Even this long later, like 2009, this 2022, okay, oh, got some yarn. So, in this project, in this sweet, sweet $3.50 Leisure Arts, this was at Lee Ward's. Anybody who's from this the Bay Area of California is where I hail from. Lee Ward's was a place way long time ago. I think Michaels bought them out, maybe. I don't know. But in the back here, there is, you know, they're always supposed to cover stuff up. I don't know. There's a cute little blanket right here I wanted to do just from reading the pattern, because I really don't read patterns on a consistent basis. You know, I like YouTube. I'm a child of YouTube. So I'll start this at a later time, but that one wasn't started yet, so I'm not considering it still needing to be finished, but this one is finished, so yay. All right, so the next one that I got finished was, I had seen this on Pamela's Adoring Crochet. She did this crochet flower garden scarf, and so it's just really cute, these little flowers and then the little greens, and it had tons of strings. I didn't tie in any of my ends, and so on both sides here it had a ton of strings to tie in. So that one's finished, and I'm very happy with that because I like that one a lot. That was pretty. Okay, and then the next thing I finished was, I saw this on Pamela's Adoring Crochet, her page. She was talking about them because she had made some, but the tutorial that I actually followed to do them is by the Turtle Trunk. And these are some really, really great mittens I had shown you. I didn't have the thumb tied on or sewn on. I didn't really like the way that turned out. I might go in there and add an extra stitch in there. But so the thumbs were not connected yet. I made these up and marked where the thumbs were supposed to go and then just never got around to tying them on. So here they're tied on. I got my thumbs tied on. See, this one I did a little bit better, I think, in connecting it. This one I kind of missed a couple of stitches. It was really hard to do because I'm not good at it. You know, the hole was, I think, like 10 or 12 stitches, and the thumb itself was only maybe 8 or something like that. So you had to go into some doubles, and I guess I might have to go in there and add an extra stitch to it. I didn't want to mess, but it's part of the stitch that I would have had to grab is part of the design of the glove, and I didn't want to throw that off, so I don't know what to do about that. I don't know what to do about that. I'll have to check that out. But these are great gloves. They were super easy to make, or mittens, and I really enjoyed making them. So if you get a chance to check that out, it again is called the Turtle Trunk, and these are called Country Cottage Mittens. Okay, so then the next one, those were all just kind of sewn in ends and sewing things that needed to be completed, projects that needed to be completed was, let's see here. I started a new basket. You guys know me and my baskets, right? And look how gorgeous this one is. I did all sorts of different color combinations and size combinations and handle combinations. I wanted another big one. Sometimes when I'm working on a blanket, I don't have, you know, I want to move it from one place to another within the house, and I want to throw it in a project bag, and I just didn't have ones that were big enough, so I started making a bunch of really big ones. And I did some color changing in the bags just kind of randomly, but with this one I was trying to do like a striping. So here I started with three colors, and I will show you those colors. Those are Just Yarn. This one is called Sea Glass. It's kind of like a mint. Vanna's Choice in purple. And then this I bought on clearance for $5.47. It's one of those giant jumbo super saver. How many did it have in it? It is covered up. Oh, here. 14 ounces is the size of the skein, and I got it for $5.47 specifically to do baskets because I knew this color would really pop. So that's what I did. These are my three colors that I used for the blanket, I mean for the basket. And I tried to go through and specifically stripe a little bit, change it up, specifically stripe, but I don't know if it just looks messy or if it actually has the look that I wanted it to have. And then I just finished it off with the purple and the mint, or the sea glass, I guess it's called. So I don't know if I love the color combination. I mean, I kind of do, I don't know, but I wanted to make another big basket. When I'm in between projects and I don't know what my next project is going to be, I kind of just start a basket so I have something to work on. So sometimes they have color meaning and sometimes they don't. This one did, but so yeah, another basket. I love them. Put these to the side. Okay. So I used an L 8mm hook for that, and it's three strands and just Red Heart Super Saver, you know, whatever yarn you've got for it. All right, the next one. Okay, so this one was kind of goofy. I'll insert a little piece here. Okay, so for those of you like myself who never ever do a swatch, this is a perfect reason why. The tutorial I watched, she used a 3.5 millimeter hook and said that at 7 rows, it should be 6 1/4 inches. So for me, my 3.5 millimeter hook at 7 rows was about 5.5 inches. So that didn't work. So I don't know if I jumped up two first. I can't remember if I did this. I did it a few weeks ago and I was waiting to complete it until I could film it for you guys. So I think I jumped up a whole hook size because that one was so small. So a 4.5 millimeter hook took me to like 6.5. Maybe, you know, she was closer to 6 1/4. So I just wanted to see what a hook in the middle of that would be. So this is a 4 millimeter hook and whoops. We are at about 6 inches. So, you know, either one of these may work for this project, maybe a little bit bigger, maybe a little bit smaller, depending on the head that it's gonna go on. But we definitely know that this one's gonna be a much, much smaller hat. So I just wanted to share that with you guys, that it sometimes pays to do the swatch first. And so this has to do with checking gauge. I make a lot of blankets because my size never, my gauge never works out right. I don't know what the heck my problem is. Sometimes I'm too big, sometimes I'm too small. So in this case, I started this beautiful jasmine stitch hat. I'll go ahead and put a little picture in. And she was just using Red Heart Super Saver with a 3.5 millimeter hook. So that's pretty small for standard 4 worsted weight. But I did that. I started with a 3.5 and you can see that the top of the hats weren't exactly the right sizes, so I tried to change up the hooks, and this is what I've got. So even the smallest one, even I did the additional ones because this first one that I did in cream, the diameter of the hat was too small, or the circumference, whatever that is, math, it was too small. And so I went ahead and continued the hat thinking it was gonna fit for somebody little, and at the end of it all, it's okay. It's super, it's, you know, there's a bunch of space up in here. It'll be all right, but it just, you know, it'll be a nice sun hat. The sun, the brim is kind of long. I like that. And it's this beautiful jasmine stitch. I am not gonna lie. The video I watched, making these YouTube videos is not easy. Sometimes it looks like it is, and sometimes it feels like it was a really good filming day, and sometimes it is horrific. So when I started to do tutorials, it was because I had seen another tutorial and was like, that was hard to follow. Let me show my family of viewers an easier, you know, tutorial. So I started to refilm some of those things that maybe I'd seen and they just were hard to follow, or maybe you guys asked for them, so I did that specifically. But in any event, I'm not trying to judge anybody else's videos whatsoever. But if I see one and it's kind of hard to follow, I want to show you guys a better way. I'm not going to do that with this stitch because I know I got the stitch. The stitch itself was easy to do, but the connections, she spoke super, super fast. And I don't know if she filmed it and then did the voiceover and had to talk quickly to keep up with how fast she was crocheting. But man, that was hard. And I didn't want to rewatch the video 50,000 times, although I kind of did. So I would get to, you know, a certain point, and then it was a new stitch or a new transition. And so I would transition each hat. So I've got 3 of them here, okay? I've got 3 of them all different sizes here. And it was a headache, let me tell you. The hat turned out really cute. I mean, I like the stitches, this little jasmine star stitch. But then she was showing like how to count the rows, lost me there, could not do it. So Amy has a little bit of troubles on things like this, but the end result for this one is, I mean, it's cute. She did this really cute little slanted box kind of edging, and I liked that. And like I said, I expected it to fit a child, and it's kind of big on me, so that's in and of itself kind of weird. But then, so the next one up is gonna be super, super big. This one has a bigger hook size. And then this one, I thought, this is gigantic and I'm not even gonna take the time to do the edging. Look how pretty that is. I really, really like this stitch. I might have to do a blanket in this. I don't know. It was a lot. So with the yellow one, I thought I'm not even going to do the rim on it. So here it is. I can't even see a thing. It's super. Hello. Anybody want to fit in here with me? This thing is massive. So maybe if I had all my hair up in a bun up on top, it would still fit good. Or maybe if I had tons of hair, you know, that would all fit good. I don't know. You know me and my hats. So I put it to the side, had to finish working on it eventually. Finally, here we are. So these were done by Creative Crocheting, and it's called the Crochet Jasmine Stitch Sun Hat. So I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed the idea of it. Once you start tripping me up on stitches though, I'm not gonna be happy about that. And I'm gonna revolt a little bit, but I finally got them finished anyway. So, yeah. Oh my goodness. Okay, the next one I finished up was, this one was an easy summer hat. No. This is the one that I redid. Okay, I wish I had that out to show you. Mikey does a hat with Yarnspirations or the Crochet Crowd called the Cotton Sun Hat, and he did it with Bernat Softy Cotton. This guy here. And I did a hat with his pattern and this yarn, but I wanted to redo the pattern, his pattern, with different yarn, so I did that, and I changed up his pattern. So it's kind of his hat and kind of not. What I did here, and I've shown, this is the part that's left over, that was, I had to still make the brim, that's all. But what the change that I did was, this is supposed to be a bean stitch and a chain one, and I didn't feel like doing the bean stitch again, so I just did two double crochets. So it gave the height of the bean stitch, and it, the double crochet, you know, two of them gave the bean and the single crochet count. So I ended up the same with my count. I just have a little bit different pattern through here. So my point being is that I still needed to make the brim, and I kind of wanted to go with like a white or a cream that was in the hat, and I wasn't really able to find a solid color in this yarn. This is the yarn. Lion Brand Comfy Cotton, and it is 50% cotton and 50% polyester, whereas the hat that Mikey made is 60% cotton and 40% acrylic. So I really wanted to try some different yarn, different fiber with the same pattern and see what difference I would get. So I did make it all in one color. It's a little bit boring, I'm not gonna lie. I like how changeable, how variable the brim becomes, because you know, you can really do a lot with it and change the way you look. But I thought maybe I'd put a band on it, or I was digging through some, when I was starting to crochet a bunch of years ago, I was making a whole bunch of headbands. And, you know, when my mom died, I got a bunch of her 3 lightweight DK, whatever yarn, that was baby stuff. She liked to make a lot of baby stuff. So I made these little flowers to go on the headbands, and I really liked them because they've got this part that kind of puffs up a little bit, so you can make them 3D. You can put a third one here, you know, a fourth one here, make them layered like that. So I really like these little flowers. Now this is acrylic, and it's in this baby blue, and I thought, okay, if I could put a couple of those on there, that might look cute. I wouldn't have to do something new. I'm reusing, recycling things that I've already made in my tote. So I don't know. I'm still thinking about that, whether I want to do, you know, like a dark blue brim, because I've got some of this in a dark blue color. If you look right at the top, right here, that skein right there is, or that cake is, this yarn in solid dark blue. So I might add those. I might do a little brim thing, but otherwise, it's finished. I'm calling it finished. This will just be an afterthought if I'm bored on a Saturday night or something. I don't know. Okay, so then you all were a part of this decision. So thank you, thank you, thank you. That's why I put this stuff out there. That's why we're all in this community of chit-chatting with friends over crochet, because you can help think of other things. You can bounce ideas off each other. I think it's fantastic. So thank you for the suggestion that I make some hats to go with the blankets. So I put it out there as a question to you guys when I did this feather and fan blanket, should I do a border? So the answer is no, I did not use the yarn to do a border. I like it the way it is. Many of you did as well. And this was the first blanket that I made with that yarn. This was a rectangle granny that I just love. And so, you know, these are both great, but I've got that yarn left and I didn't know, you know, do I border? Do I make small stuff? What do I do? So you guys suggested that I made a hat, and so I made a couple of hats. So this is where I started with, because I had of the scraps, I had mostly blue, this dark blue. So I thought, okay, I'm gonna use some of that. Oh, and I got a bunch of this turquoise blue. So I'm gonna use a bunch of that. And then I thought, well, I do wanna give it some stripes. I do wanna give it some of the rest of the coloring. So I'm weighing all out the different colors. I, you know, tried to figure out how many I could do and make it even. So this is a nice little hat. It is, my 8 and 9 is, oops. The feather and fan blanket I made from Fiber Spider, and that was 3 full cakes plus a whole bunch of partials. So I'm calling the feather and fan, I call that 4 plus cakes. And then the rectangle granny that I made, that I used 3 cakes, and that came out to be 44 by 35. I didn't get the measurement on the feather and fan, but it's full length, comes up to here-ish, full width for me. So, what I made were these two hats that are back day. Crystal made these unisex beanie. Rain Must Fall is the name of the blanket, is the name of the hats. And it's got these little bean stitches. I think that's what they were. These little bean stitches in between. So it gives a nice texturing. And so that was really cute. And I thought, after I'd just done Mikey's bean stitch hat as well. So this was the second one that I made. After I made this one, and I put a little crab border on it, a little reverse single crochet crab border. I like that. And it's a little too small for me, so that's perfect, because these were supposed to be like for teens or young adults, or little girls even too. This one's a little bit smaller, and I like the way that the striping turned out. I only had a little tiny bit of purple. I would have liked more purple. And so with a hat and using pink, you want to always be wary of making the top look like a female part. And so I was really paying close attention to how much pink was going to be on the topmost round part, if you get my understanding. So I think these turned out really, really cute. And this one's a little bit smaller, as you can see. Oops. The pink one's just a little bit smaller. I went down a hook size. So this one I used with a 5 millimeter hook, and this one I used a 4.5 hook, a 4.5 millimeter hook. So I thought those turned out really cute. So thank you, thank you, thank you for the advice to do some hats, some matching hats. I'd never really done that before, like with baby blankets. I'll make baby clothes and a hat and booties and stuff, and I'll make blankets, but I generally don't do a blanket with a hat, and I think it's a great idea. So that yarn got used, and used well. Thank you very much. I did want to share with you guys kind of what became a fail. I used, this was a new skein to me, and I was very excited to get it, the Mandela Tweed stripes. And the color is very pretty. It's called Horseshoe. See, there's that darker blue in there as well. So it's very, very pretty. I really, really liked the colorway. And it is 100% acrylic, although it doesn't feel like that to me, but I don't know. So it's a 4. It feels really light, like a 3, but it is a 4. And I tried a couple of different scarves. Look, I got a whole nother one down in here. It just wasn't working out for me. So I frogged a bunch of stuff and just put it put the skein away. I'll have to come back to do that later. So that was in my project pile before I took that picture. And I just decided he's a no-go. He's going to go back to the starting board, back to the drawing board as it is, and we'll figure out something later with him. So that was all that I have for part one, my update of part one of my update of my unfinished projects, which are now finished. And I'm super, super excited because, again, I've told you guys before, one of my stress points is when I'm done with working on everything, what do I do now? What is my next project going to be? I don't like not knowing what my next project is going to be. So I started to create in my head, or my sense of my the way that I work here, I'm calling them nods. It's the next on deck. So I may not have started it yet, but I have in my idea. I mean, I have an idea in my mind what yarn I'm going to use and what pattern I'm going to use. So I will a lot of times pull out that yarn and that pattern and put them together on a separate shelf so that that's what's next on deck. That's the next batter up. So when I'm done with everything else, I know I'm going to start on that next. And I think I have four. One, two, three. I already have four nods. So I'm super excited because I'm not going to have like downtime. So here was part one. I still have a whole bunch to do that will be part two, maybe even a part three. Some things that I found after I took that picture that aren't even in there that I'll tell you about, about on a whole separate video, because I know that's going to take me a bunch. So I'm just check back with me for next updates on my unfinished projects. And when those are all completed, I'll have four or five projects to have, to get going and share with you guys. So that's all I've got for today. Thank you so much for sitting with me. I really, really do appreciate your time. This makes me so happy. I love to share my crochet, and your comments and your support and the love that you guys share with me. I appreciate it so much. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Have a wonderfully blessed day, and I'll see you again. Bye-bye.